Hello there, so this is just a short video on how to keep your reference waveforms on the screen whilst you're capturing live data. Now there are a number of ways to do this, but one that I really like the look of is from a user online, and he's got two viewports up, one with the reference waveform and your known good capture if you like, and then the live data underneath. So I wanted just to demonstrate how to do that, and we're going to do it in both PicoScope 6 and PicoScope 7 to show you the differences and how to get the two screens to work. So we'll start off in 6. So what we're going to do is we're going to load in a known good reference waveform, and this could be one from the waveform library browser or one that you've already got saved. So we're going to go to open, and I have a number to choose from. So I'm going to go cam, crank, and we'll have, there we go. So we'll have both the camshafts and an ignition current sync as well. So we're going to put that on the screen. It's obviously quite a long capture. You could opt for one that's shorter, but now, if we were to keep everything the same as what it is, so if we were to set up our actual live data capture in exactly the same way, then we can leave all these settings on the screen, so everything's set up for you. So obviously, bear in mind, anything with current clamps, make sure that you've got the right current clamp on the screen. This is obviously a 60 amp in 20 amp mode, and then obviously the ranging and the scaling will all be correct. So just bear that little that thing in mind. Now, very quickly, in PicoScope 6, what we can do is we can right click and then we can just go reference waveforms. Now I'm only really interested in the cam and crank signal, so I'm going to do a reference of A, B, C, and that will do us. So now obviously it's looking extremely messy on the screen right now. So what we're going to do now is obviously split all this up into two different viewpoints. So if you go up to views and then add view and scope, it will load in underneath another viewport. Now if we look at the two, this one looks like the original capture that we had at the beginning. Now if we right click again, we can see that the active channels in view are A, B, C and D, and our reference ones are actually hidden. So we're going to keep that as it is, but in the top viewport, so again just navigate up to the top and right click on the grid here, and then we can see that we've got all of them actually active. Now we don't really want the live ones anymore, so we're going to get rid of all of those, including channel D. We're not really interested in channel D for a cam crank sync, it's just purely as a trigger to keep things on the screen. Now again, everything's still looking a little bit bunched up, so we could just separate them by moving the axis around and doing as so. Or the other way of doing it is actually you can right click and there is an auto arrange axis. Now be careful here because it can actually change the scaling, so things will look different. I tend to just like to move them around and then adjust the scaling if I need to get everything to fit. But as a quick solution, obviously the auto arrange is there just to help out with that point. So again, now this will obviously stay here now, so we can make all our amendments, we can zoom in, we can treat this as a completely different scope capture. We could add rotation horizontal and nothing's affected in the one below. So I'm not actually at a car at the moment to do a live demonstration, but if we were to press start, as you can see, this one's stayed exactly the same, and now at the bottom we've got everything running. And I think if we move the channels around, we can actually have all of them identified separately. Again, auto arrange or just move the axis by shifting up and down. So I think we can see this is actually quite useful. Again, you might not have even had a trigger at that point. So then it's just a case of locating two rotations of crankshaft to give you some reference points on here. So we can see obviously we've got two towers there, if you like, from which one was that? That's the intake camshaft sensor. So we can sort of use them as reference points to actually then match up with our live data and actually compare a cam crank sync. Okay, so that's how it is in 6. Now, if we do the same type of measurement in 7, so if we go to 7, now this hasn't got a scope connected, so we are just in demo mode on here. But again, we're going to use the same principle. We're going to open up an existing an existing capture. I'm trying to remember which one it was now. So let's just go back quickly. Exhaust cam, primary ignition current. Right, okay. Back to PicoScope 7. Cam. So again, everything's on the screen as it was before. So you have to do something slightly different here because there's no right-click functionality at the moment. So if we go to Views, and then we want to click on References. So sorry, that should be References first. We want to click on the References button. We get this pop-out. Same thing again was how it was in 6. So what we're going to do is just we're going to click. We're just going to add. Going to add them all in. So actually I've added channel D in. I didn't really want to add in channel D, so if you do want any, then obviously the manage is here, so we can take to channel D and we can remove. We can see that they've actually loaded in the colors as per 6 does, so it will put the default colors. If you want to change the names or anything like that, you can do all of that in this section here. Again, for exporting, you can actually save, and it will save your reference waveforms to a library where you can obviously call them upon whenever you need them again. So click anywhere outside the grid and then it collapses everything. Now again, everything's looking a little bit messy. So if we go to Views, now we can click Scope. As before, now it's just put the live one underneath. And in the top viewport, we can see everything's still here. So again, if we go back to Views and we've got the Show Hide Channels here, so we can actually deselect the ones that we don't want. Now, should we just be left with our references? So again, dragging along the side will actually move your axes around. If you want to do any scaling in 7, we could actually just hover over the axis if you're using a mouse. If you're using a tablet, there is the option to pinch on this axis as well, and that will actually adjust your scaling. So you can see here, I'm just rotating the mouse wheel at the moment. You can see how the scaling's changing. You also can do this from within the channel options. So you have to go to display, and then you have the options here to actually change what you have. Now, obviously, this is a reference waveform in the top, so bear that in mind as well. So again, we've got the vertical scale here. So this is how we change it in 7 for your references. Again, at the bottom, I'm just going to literally use my mouse wheel just to change the scaling, just a touch, just to bring everything to view a little bit better. You do also have the option now to actually pull that out completely, and if you wanted to, maximize the whole screen. That's another option. If you want to keep your reference on, then you actually also have the option to move it to the side, should you wish. So there's just a bit more flexibility in 7 with how you want to set things up to view it. You can also actually drag this toolbar to change the height of it, so you can actually have a bigger increased area of the actual data, or actually vice versa, you might want the actual known good slightly bigger so you can see it. So there's all these options that's still present. But I hope that helps. Keep the feedback coming in for 7, because we do constantly want to keep making it better and improve it all the time. And keep an eye out for the software updates, because there will be new features coming as and when. So do keep letting us know. I hope this helps, and take care of yourselves out there, everybody.